peanut dust and corn husks drifting through the air tonight. The marching band's warming up under the football lights. There's tractor trailers backed up down by the elevators. Train track grain car will roll in later. Get filled up and head on. So tank up and make another round. There's a big red moon coming up in the sky. Combines cutting in a staggered line. The only time of year we miss the church bells chime. It's harvest time. There's a thermos and a water jug cab. A set of socket wrenches wrapped up in a greasy red rag. Bobby's mother pulls in the field bringing us supper. We grab a bite and make sure to hug her. Saddle back up and let the big wheels roll. It's harvest time in this little town. Time to bring it on in. Fill the diesel tank up and make another round. There's a big red moon coming up in the sky. Combines cutting in a staggered line. The only time of year we miss the church bells chime. It's harvest time. Off my boots in the laundry room. We'll start it all over tomorrow at noon. Till it's all done. Until we're all done. It's harvest time in this little town. Time to bring it on in. Pay the loans down. Fill the diesel tank up and make another round. There's a big red moon coming up in the sky. Combines cutting in a staggered line. The only time of year we miss the church bells chime. It's harvest time. It's harvest time.
John Deere lunch kit and a thermos full of Kool-Aid. September harvest and I missed another school day. 14 hours worth of work and dirt were lessons learned. Waist deep in those fields of gold. 7 tons of steel and a 12-year-old. Working hard just to keep it in a straight line. On the combine. Hand it down overalls and an AM radio. Try to get it right the first time and take it slow. Alabama singing in a hurry and I don't know why.
I'm in a hurry to get things done.
Black clouds and it starts to rain. Running short on time and out of faith. Nothing you can do but pray for the sun to shine on the combine. Every time I climb that ladder, it takes me back to things that matter.
Thank you.
Friday night. First date dinner in the cabin beneath the moonlight. Cushion on a 5-gallon pail, riding shotgun. Time goes by like those waves of gray, but I remember it like yesterday, where I fell in love for the first time. On the combine. Now every time I climb that ladder, it takes me back.
Awakened by the crowing of a rooster, while the night's dew is still heavy on the ground, and the voice of Uncle Ben seems to break the morning silence, bringing lights to windows all around. Well, it's time to rise and shine and start another hard work day. Get the cows in and start the milking chores. It's nice to think about it, maybe even visit, but I wonder could I live there anymore. Something about the smell of cornbread, cooking on a wood stove, seems to bring a picture to my mind of a little 3-room house with Mama in the kitchen. But she can't stop to talk, ain't got the time. She's a fixing Daddy's supper, he's a working overtime, trying to pay our bill at the grocery store. It's nice to think about it, maybe even visit, but I wonder could I live there anymore. As I think about my childhood and of my old hometown, I don't really miss them like before. It's nice to think about it, maybe even visit, but I wonder could I live there anymore.
While resting one evening by the side of the road, I saw an old farmer in a field he'd just hoed. His face was all brown and wrinkled by the sun and the wind. And he was talking to the Lord just like he'd be talking to a friend. "Well, sir," he said with his voice calm and quiet, "them corn tassels need sacking. Got no string to tie it. Hadn't a raining so long that the fields is mighty dusty. And it's been so unbearable hot that the kids is even getting fussy. Now that grass down in the pasture, it should be knee high. If we could just have a little shower, Lord, it might keep the cow from going dry. Oh, but listen to me talking. You'd think I wasn't grateful. Why, if you didn't know me so well, Lord, you'd think I was downright hateful. You'd think I'd forgot about that new calf that you sent, and the money in the mail that took care of the rent. Ma's cold's better, and Johnny's home in the Navy, and that good Sunday dinner of chicken and dumplings and gravy. And that new preacher you sent us, Lord, he's sure a fine young man. Why, he just converting them sinners to beat the band. Well, guess I'll mosey on home now, Lord. Won't take no more of your time. Guess there's plenty folks hereabout that's waiting to ring your line. Evening to you, Lord, and watch over us tonight. Don't you worry about us none, Lord. Everything's gonna be all right."
Daddy was a dreamer, Hannah was his dream. He worked two jobs to buy 10 acres and a wedding ring. Times were getting harder and the land wasn't much, but Daddy held on cause he drew his dreams from Hannah's tender touch. As they lay together in the night, she whispered to him while he held her tight,
"Plant your love in a field of dreams. Water that love from the kindness stream.
Was a lover, Hannah was his love. In their eyes a vision burned brighter than the stars above. Believing in each other, trusting in God's plan, sowing their seeds and sinking their roots in the heart of the land. When the spring rain came,